Сблъсъци възникнаха между полиция и протестиращи в Париж. Франция протестира срещу планирани от правителството реформи в трудовото законодателство. Повече от 200 демонстрации огласиха цялата страна. В градовете Нант и Рен също се стигна до сблъсъци. В масовия протест се включиха профсъюзи и студентски организации.
Идеята е да сортир ла мобилизацион фас а ла лоа травай до се сол кадр традиционел. Се деciде апре ла манифестацион ду 31 mars, on ne rentre pas chez nous. On investit l'espace public, on se rencontre, on discute, on partage et on montre aux puissants que nous valons mieux qu'eux, que nous sommes plus nombreux, plus déterminés qu'eux et que nous ne voulons plus nous faire écraser pour permettre à quelques-uns de s'enrichir indécemment. Rendez-vous est donné le 31 au soir à République et malgré la pluie, les gens sont là. Très vite, ils s'assoient, discutent, apprennent à réfléchir et à prendre des décisions ensemble. Des personnes aux histoires diverses, vieux militants, jeunes en galère ou simples curieux, mais partageant tous l'impression que le monde pourrait tourner beaucoup mieux. La loi travail n'est qu'un élément parmi d'autres. Ce qui rassemble, c'est un ressenti partagé, celui que les choses fonctionneraient d'une meilleure manière sans les milliardaires, politiciens, experts en tout genre qui plongent le pays dans la crise depuis des décennies. L'impression, au-delà des différences, de s'être tous fait déposséder d'une partie de nos vies par un système et de devoir se battre pour reconquérir des choses essentielles comme la dignité et la démocratie. Les personnes se trouvant sur la place sont de plus en plus nombreuses. Elles tiennent chaque jour des assemblées populaires où chacun peut prendre la parole et apprend à écouter les autres selon des règles édictées collectivement. Elles se rassemblent en commission pour préparer des actions concrètes ou pour améliorer la vie collective, construire des campements, organiser le ravitaillement en fonction des besoins de chacun.
Le 46 mars, sur la place de la République, quand des centaines de personnes investissaient un lieu pour faire de la politique dans le sens premier du terme, organiser le vivre ensemble. Un espace démocratique de dialogue où l'on pense les choses ensemble. Quelle merveilleuse synergie de groupe, quelle ouverture au dialogue, quel engagement qui renoue enfin avec le véritable espace démocratique, celui du débat entre personnes concernées. Parce que la démocratie, ça n'est pas que le vote.
La démocratie, c'est le vote.
Sinon, d'essayer de tenter de changer certaines choses, de voir que le peuple peut se diriger lui-même. Parce que sinon, qu'il pourrait ?
Et dans une volonté de s'ouvrir à toutes les personnes qui pourraient être concernées, elles se forment à diffuser largement ce qu'elles sont en train de créer. C'est ainsi que, grâce à l'application Periscope, l'Assemblée Générale du 3 avril ou du 34 mars a pu être suivie en direct par plus de 80 000 personnes. Cette ouverture, tant aux outils d'aujourd'hui qu'aux problèmes touchant l'immense majorité des citoyens, cette volonté de mieux faire, d'avancer ensemble, sans parti, sans bannière, sans étiquette, semble répondre à une attente commune enfouie depuis trop longtemps. Ainsi, plus de 60% des Français sont favorables au mouvement Nuit Debout et le rejoindraient s'ils le pouvaient, preuve s'il en est que les exigences de dignité et de démocratie dépassent largement les clivages traditionnels. Autre preuve de cette correspondance entre les aspirations portées par la Nuit Debout et celles qui existent en chacun de nous, le mouvement est en train de sortir totalement de sa localisation parisienne et de gagner de nombreuses villes du pays. À Toulouse, à Nantes, à Bordeaux, mais également à Orléans, à Perpignan, à Tulle, à Lorient, à Avignon. Les places pour échanger et faire entendre leur voix. Le mouvement commence également à s'étendre au reste de l'Europe avec des nuits debout organisées à Berlin, à Madrid et dans plusieurs villes de Belgique. De quoi redorer l'image de la France, trop longtemps restée silencieuse sur le plan international et souvent salie par les décisions irresponsables prises par les gouvernants.
I think the labor law was only a pretext. For me, my friends and other people who are here, it's a way to show that we're fed up with just about everything.
There are no leaders nor activist groups behind the movement.
The site has become a magnet for people who want to show their discontent.
We are not here to make a claim. We are here to make a stand against the government's methods that are not democratic.
While many protest the labor law, others denounce increased security measures put in place after the November terrorist attacks and the prolonged state of emergency. Long-standing social problems like housing, jobs and inequality are also hot topics.
One activist on Twitter saying that the Place de la République is the new beating heart of popular democracy. A conscious people are standing up. And another one here, this is what democracy looks like, he says. Thousands in the General Assembly discussing social justice.
We have to reclaim our vocabulary to reclaim our ideas.
Protesters criticize the government, which they say is controlled by the richest segments of society. They want to make France more democratic by changing the constitution.
Night Rising is a citizens' revolt. Their goal is to retake power from oligarchs, the richest 1% of the population. To do that, they need to change institutions. This means changing the constitution.
What is so inspiring there is that the way that they connect with each other, the way they talk together, the way they take such a long time to listen to each and everyone. After 5-6 hours of these general assemblies, it's really a movement that is with very strong personal connections. In 2011, all this movement in Wall Street, in Occupy Wall Street, in Spain and everywhere, were just opposed to political party. They wanted to reclaim politics from parties. And that's exactly what's happening today at the Place de la République.
Зредици избухнаха и в Париж, и Монпелие. Сблъсъците бяха част от протестите на движението Будни цяла нощ във Франция. Вече две седмици предимно ученици и студенти протестират срещу промените в трудовото законодателство, които дават повече права на работодателите. На няколко места протестът прерасна в сблъсъци с полицията. Бяха подпалени автомобили и изпочупени витрини. Има няколко арестувани. В Париж младежите всяка вечер окупират площад в центъра. Преди три дни властите използваха сила, за да разчистят протеста, но хората се събраха отново още на следващия ден.
Бъдещето трябва да се определя от гражданите, а не от политиците. Хиляди французи са убедени в това и вече три седмици го демонстрират на ключови места, като площада на Републиката в Париж.
Тези хора работят във фабриките. Те осъществяват производството. На практика цялата ни икономика е в техни ръце. Те имат власт над събитията и ние сме тук, за да ги мобилизираме.
В началото медиите подценяваха гражданския протест, който обаче се превърна в мощно социално явление и днес е задължителна тема за всяка новинарска емисия. Будните нощем имат завидно добър уебсайт, изключително ефикасна и професионална комуникация в социалните мрежи и собствено радио.
Смисълът на тези събирания будни нощи е да повярваме на нашата сила, защото нямаме повече доверие на нашите управляващи.
Всяка гражданска инициатива може да бъде представена в рамките на 5 минути пред един от десетките комитети, организирани по теми. Вечер общо събрание гласува и приема най-добрите идеи на будните нощи, които изглеждат по-бодри от всякога.
The mere fact that a whole lot of people are spontaneously assembling, that constitutes a real challenge to power in France, because French political and corporate elites are used to having the running of the country stitched up in an entre-soi between themselves, which this movement is really, I think, constituting a meaningful counterpower towards. The aim of the movement probably goes beyond, or the discussions at least go beyond, just wanting to have an influence on party politics as it exists in France at the moment. I think there's quite a radical putting into question of the usual mechanisms of parliamentary democracy. The leaderlessness of the Nuit Debout movement is really about, perhaps, as I see it anyway, a rejection of the typical means of party organization and political representation and spokespersonship that are associated with the traditional business as usual politics in a social democracy like France. Obviously, the movement has people who are more involved than others, and so people who could be described as leaders in that sense. But the rejection of designating any people in that way, I think, is a way of affirming the real necessity of trying to do politics differently and in a way that can engage people. At the moment, the signs are very positive that this movement has actually put its finger on the pulse of French society and that it's succeeding in really crystallising very deeply held misgivings and concerns about the way that the two-party system that we have here, where essentially left and right alternate, more or less, just simply doesn't serve the interests of ordinary people, but serves the interests of capital. I think that's... If Nuit Debout does nothing else, and I think we can expect much more of it, if it does nothing else, it will really have put that agenda front and centre in French consciousness.
Part of Nuit Debout's message is that everyone's equal. There are no bosses. And the goal is revolution.
I want to drive out the bosses. We have to confiscate their property and govern ourselves. Not let capital rule, but decide for ourselves how we're going to work. Work shouldn't be all about profits, but about the common good. Only an open-ended strike can pressure the government or even bring it down. Normally, people strike for one day. The government doesn't care about that, even if millions of people collect in the streets. To reach the government and the bosses, we have to blockade the country's economy. The state of emergency was the end of the last bit of democracy we had. Friends of mine who fight against nuclear power were put under house arrest at exactly the same time as the climate change conference here in Paris. That way, they wanted to prevent all political activism. The state is worried because we might topple the system. If the workers join forces, they can oust the oligarchs and the employers. We have the know-how, the ability, and the energy. All they can do is eat, sleep, and get rich at our expense. They have no productive abilities.
Сблъсъци и арести във Франция на поредния протест срещу реформите в трудовото законодателство. В Париж силите за борба с безредиците използваха сълзотворен газ срещу група младежи, които ги замериха с бомбички. На други места в страната спорадични стачки и демонстрации нарушиха трафика по външните линии и доведоха до анулиране на полети на парижското летище Орли. Протестиращите настояват за оттегляне на плана за реформа, който предвижда по-лесно освобождаване от работа.
Un mois plus tard, vendredi 60 mars, en calendrier nuit de boutiste, ça débat toujours sous l'œil de la République. Mais pour aller où?
Avant de rencontrer les syndicats, il faut qu'on sache nous-mêmes ce qu'on est et savoir ce qu'on veut préserver. Si on s'allie avec les syndicats et qu'on réussit à faire tomber la loi travail, il ne faudrait pas que ce soit que ça mette fin à Nuit Debout qui est en train de créer quelque chose de plus profond.
Sous la pluie, les citoyens de la place débriefent la prise de parole de syndicalistes jeudi, jour de manifestation contre le texte El Khomri. Avec une question... Quel avenir pour le mouvement?
Il va falloir choisir entre continuer sur ce mode-là au risque qui se dilue ou accélérer le mouvement. Ça ne veut pas dire créer un parti, ça ne veut pas dire se soumettre au syndicat, ça veut dire collaborer et faire converger les luttes pour qu'on soit plus efficace et qu'on soit entendu.
Être plus efficace, pour certains, ce ne serait pas une question d'alliance, mais plutôt de temps.
Ça fait un mois qu'on se retrouve seulement. C'est pas évident de construire des idées politiques en si peu de temps et à autant de monde en ayant un fonctionnement très démocratique.
Patience ou stratégie, pour Camille, Yanis et Jocelyn, le travail continue afin de pérenniser cette nouvelle manière de faire de la politique en évitant toute récupération.
Now I feel truly in touch with myself, because now I'm living my political values and ideas all the time. I'm no longer afraid of people, migrants or otherwise. I'm no longer afraid at all.
Word comes through that the strike will not be continued for now.
We're still at the beginning. The common cause that's taken shape here in the demonstration and the unrest is the starting signal for events that could get even more radical.
dans le contexte actuel, voir que les citoyens se réveillent, échangent et prennent confiance en eux tous ensemble est certainement une très bonne nouvelle. Chacun prend conscience qu'il a beaucoup plus en commun avec son voisin que ce que les discours habituels des politiques et des médias veulent nous laisser croire. Alors si vous aussi, vous en avez assez de l'absurdité du monde tel qu'on nous le vend, n'hésitez pas à vous rendre sur les places pour échanger. Tous ensemble, nous sommes sans doute capables de trouver des solutions à nos problèmes. Ça s'appelle la démocratie.
Global Debout, International Day of Action on May 15, 2016. We call for a Global Debout Day of Action on May 15. We call on people's movements across the world to mobilize for justice and real democracy. 1 million people mobilized in Paris, and the movement Moot Debout continues to grow. In numerous French and foreign cities, Moot Debout, Night on Our Feet, is a light in the dark. It gives testimony to our hopes, dreams and common rebellions, those who have taken the squares in the past, and those who are taking them now. We know something is happening. The struggle for a better world is global and without borders. Let's construct together a global spring of resistance. Moot Debout's first aim is to create a space for the convergence of struggles. There exist numerous links between social movements in all four corners of the world, from unemployment to the imposition of the financial markets, from the destruction of the environment to war and unacceptable inequality. In response to a system based on competition and individualism, we answer with the solidarity, participatory democracy and collective action. Our differences are not a source of divisions, but rather our strength, as we complement each other's struggles. We are neither listened nor represented by the current economic system. We are the 99%, and we are here to reject the financial and political rule of the 1% and their world. We are here to take back our cities, our places of work and our lives. We will rise up together for a global day of action on May 15th. Moot Debout everywhere. Hashtag Global Debout. We'll be right back.
Expliquer directement dans la rue, nous allons pratiquer une politique de démocratie directe.
The 10th anniversary of De Gaulle's return to power. Hundreds of thousands of workers join the students in an act of public defiance. Nowhere in the world have workers responded so massively to student initiative. It is a confrontation with the whole authoritarian heritage. Yet an oblique, almost playful confrontation. It does not antagonize the public and keeps the authorities off balance. Chanting of slogans echoes in the streets.
Down with the bourgeois university.
University of the people.
All power to the workers. French police, Nazi SS.
Stop fascism here.
At the Sorbonne, the collapse of traditional authority is total. The police are withdrawn from the Latin Quarter and the students take charge, both of the university and of the surrounding streets. Regular academic functions cease. The professorial nobility commits corporate suicide. The university gets its revolutionary government, its student Soviet, founded on continuous discussion. Students reject expertise, hierarchy, academic and political neutrality. The lecture halls and courtyards are filled with endless discussion. Seriousness is combined with freedom from tension. People want to talk, to listen, to express themselves, to exchange views. Everything is put into question. The role of the student in the university, the role of the university in society, are re-examined as action committees spring up in every institution of higher education. Traditional institutions appear to collapse of their own weight into popular democracies. The students appear to be launching a new civilization. Discussion centers around the ideals of participation and self-expression. An increased share in decision-making and guarantees for expression become both the means and ends of the revolution. The political demands of a minority of workers, usually younger ones, and the more broadly held economic demands of unions provide the stated goals for the strike. Demands for worker control and the 40-hour week, for participation and higher wages, appear side by side. On May 22nd, hundreds of thousands again take to the streets. Half holiday, half revolution, the dissatisfied citizens refuse to recognize the legitimacy of representative authority. The demonstrators reject traditional political processes as a farce, chanting, "Voting is whoring, election is prostitution." The Chamber of Deputies is dubbed the Chamber of Sellouts.
Bismarck, qui n'est pas en peine d'affamer les Parisiens, nous demande la Lorraine, l'Alsace et les Alsaciens, la honte pour nos soldats, des milliards à son service.
Ah, c'est un armistice, Bismarck, n'en voulons pas.
On nous permettra du reste, pendant 20 à 25 jours, de manger ce qui nous reste de vieux chars, de rats et d'ours. Mais plus le moindre repas après le vote au comice.
Ah, c'est à ton armistice, Bismarck, n'en voulons pas.
Je fais la guerre à l'Empire, disait le maître effronté.
Was that the wealthiest people had already fled the city because they were frightened of revolution. Essentially, the government withdrew. The state actually left the city, and the city was left with no officials, no functionaries, no police, no magistrates. It was an incredible opportunity in a sense, and the working class took advantage of it. They began to lead their own lives. And for 72 days, they did so. Association, of cooperation, of mutual aid, examples of what lives look like when they're really emancipating themselves, you know, when they are going about the whole process of essentially dismantling a state apparatus, step by step dismantling of state bureaucracy in an incredibly short bit of time. It's an example, an incredible example of lives led differently and outside of the path that was subsequently taken by, say, capitalist modernization on the one hand, or, you know, the kind of erecting of state managed socialism on the other. What was valuable about the commune was their own working existence. They transferred all public services into the hands of the commune. Now, what that meant was that tasks still existed, but they could be performed by anybody, anywhere, and at a worker's salary. They suppressed the standing army and replaced it with the armed people. Meaningful for us today when we look at attempts to kind of reorganize our lives in terms of certain notions of regional self-sufficiency, you know, or delinking from various kinds of transnational economic structures like the World Bank or anything like that. Direct cooperation of all energies, all intelligences, all involved in every single detail of everyday life. Different resonances in a word like that. There's, you know, the desire to organize your own social life. There's a powerful demand for local autonomy.
Чете за Париж, дето робот, човекот кој речуе думите му, разумот му, улавя се за крајност и се бори на живот и смрт, доколкото му позволява средствата, които са ниски, защото са малки, а малки само за тој, защото им са ги отнели господарите. Лудите не може никој утеши, бесните не може никој окрути. Свобода или смрт, хляб или куршум, за да направих скитника граждани. И от него да зависи градът, а не той от града.
Oh. some workers keep work on the mountains of death. Oh, some workers.